Hey guys, welcome back to my program. And now you have to understand, you have to get to a point in your life where you're speaking your mind, letting people know your thoughts, you know, trying to every single day encourage yourself to grow, to become a better version of yourself, and to do something that's going to help your life. But there's one thing that I want to talk about in this video, and that's masturbation and what I've learned about it, okay? And now, many people watch pornography, okay, and they masturbate to pornography, okay? And I found myself in my life doing this many times, okay, multiple times, a lot of times, masturbating to porn. And you have to understand that it never made me truly at peace. You know, I was never at peace with myself for watching another guy have sex with a beautiful woman that I only dreamt of having sex with. You know, and besides that, masturbating to it, for example. But you have to understand that I found a new way. And if you really listen to me in this video, you'll pick up this information. You'll pick up on the information on how you can aerate, okay, you can aerate while you masturbate. And why is this important? Because when you aerate while you masturbate, you won't watch porn. Do you know why? Because aerating stimulates your mind, and you can talk about things while you are aerating with your hand or with your pen. You can use your left hand, for example, or right hand, or whatever it is, and you can air write with it while masturbating, for example, and you can be talking about things like what you find attractive while you masturbate, and you can just talk to yourself with your hand, and you'll find that this stimulates your mind, and you will not even go to pornography to watch pornography, because you already have your hand to do your stimulation for you. You understand? Which means that while you're masturbating with one hand, you're air writing with the other hand. Okay, and this is how I found for myself to get away from pornography, because I had a pornography addiction. Okay, and I no longer watch pornography because I air write while masturbating. Okay, and this is funny because many people don't know this. Many people don't know what air writing is. But it's a useful technique I use. I use a pen, okay, I write with my left hand. I air write with my left hand, and then I just masturbate with my right hand, okay? But you have to understand that this helps me basically to talk with myself with my hand, okay? And while I'm talking with my hand, I'm talking about things like whatever I find attractive about myself, or whatever I'm learning, for example. I learn something and I'm actually stimulating my mind while air writing, while I'm actually masturbating, and it's working, and I'm not even going back to porn, you know. So you have to realize that I no longer need the stimulation from pornography to masturbate. Do you understand? So I no longer have to open a browser for porn to watch porn to masturbate to porn when I have air writing and masturbation. You understand me? So that's the technique I use to be able to stay away from porn. Basically, air writing with masturbation. And it's gold. It's amazing because I can talk to myself, I can lead my direction, I can say whatever I want to say in my air writing with myself while masturbating. And I find it turns me on, and you know, I can talk about my fantasies while I'm masturbating. I can talk about whatever I want with myself inside my inner dialogue with myself. And I find this is a massive breakthrough in my life to stay away from porn forever. You understand? I no longer have to watch porn. I no longer have to watch other guys having sex with beautiful women. You know? I no longer have to contribute to that pornography field in life. You know? And I had a lot of shame watching porn, and it made me feel shit. Okay? Also, the guilt, the shame around it, you know, comparison, you know, always comparing my penis to their penis, or how much they squirt in terms of their sperm at whatever, you know, like a woman and stuff, and like how much, like for example, just the comparisons, you know, of things that happen in porn that hasn't happened in my life. You know, so, and then it's like, from this point on, you have to understand, many people compare to porn, and it's very unrealistic, and it's not something that is actually happening in your own life. Although, you can understand that once you compare to pornography, then you start feeling low self-esteem, you start feeling anxiety, you start feeling shy. You know, you start, when you watch porn, you feel shy. You feel anxious to talk to a woman or to a man. You know, and and porn has a lot of relationship problems with people. You know, it's hard for you to make friends. It's hard for you to build attraction to someone in life. And it's just hard to do relationships and friendships with people when you're consuming pornography. That's been my experience in life, you know. And also, not just that, but porn degrades people. You know, porn degrades and objectifies women and men, you know, and you don't want to degrade yourself. You don't want to be less than you are. You know, you want to be able to talk and not shy away from a conversation. You want to be able to say whatever is on your mind. You want to be able to open up and blossom, you know. So I find air writing with masturbation is how I overcame pornography, basically, because I needed something to stimulate my mind while I masturbate, and I found air writing helps me with that. But with air writing, what I do specifically with air writing is I use Code Zero. And this is my technique that I use in my air writing. Basically, you can get my book, Code Zero, The Code of Danny Milivojevic, on amazon.com.au. And it's just a bunch of code, you know, a bunch of code. Just coming back to the word I, you know, but if you want, I promise you, if you want more detail about what Code Zero is, then please check out my book, Code Zero, The Code of Danny Milivojevic. You can find it on Google. And you have to understand that, you have to understand that once you read this book, for example, what's going to happen is you're going to find how I talk Code Zero in my daily life, okay? And Code Zero is a bunch of thoughts basically coming back to the word I. Yeah, so I love you. So you have to understand, I'm always coming back to that word I. You understand, in my communication. That's all Code Zero is. But if, let's say you want a better description of what Code Zero is, then go check out the book, because that book is going to show you how I air write. You understand? And that's what I use in my daily life now. While masturbating, I air write, for example. But you have to understand that I no longer go to porn. I no longer watch porn. And I'm starting to feel much better about myself. I'm starting to have much more natural orgasms around whatever's happening inside of me. Inside of me, personally, for example, in terms of imagination, you know, so I'm always talking to myself in daily life with my air writing. I use my index finger, I use a pen, I use my boogie board, which is an e-writer. I do continual line writing. I write in my laptop, I write in my phone, I just write, you know, I just write any way I can write, I do that, okay? I use both index fingers, I use both hands, you know, I pray a lot, for example, you know, like I talk to God here and there, you know, as much as I can. But you have to understand that in life, once you are pursuing your dreams, you get to a stage that eventually you're going to say to yourself, wow, what's going on with my life? You know, like, because the thing is that you had this dream 10 years ago to be the person you are now. And then you have a passion with what you're doing today. You have a passion, okay, about something. And it's just like pursuing that passion over and over again, over and over again. And, you know, just make sure you're not losing faith. Make sure you're not losing yourself in the process. You know, make sure that you're happy in your life, that you're trying to get to a better stage in life, that you're trying to help yourself to grow, that you're trying to help yourself to become a better version of yourself. You know, so try to study your life, try to give massive breakthroughs in life, try to give everything of your heart. You know, once you realize that you can do anything you set your mind to, you realize that there's so much potential inside of you that you just have to unlock it. You have to unlock your ability to be able to give everything of your heart so that you can become that version of yourself that you've always dreamt about. You know, so every single day, focus on yourself, focus on this technique I gave you in my audio program here, and try to really capture a better life for yourself. Try to every single day understand where you're going, your goals, what can you do with your life to succeed. You know, ask yourself questions, ask questions in conversations. Make sure other people are talking more than you in a conversation. Just ask questions about anything, you know. Open up and try to find common interests about whatever it is you guys are interested about. Try to find something to bond over with people, and try to just be nice without being too pushy, you know. So don't go straight away for personal questions. Try to talk about your surroundings, you know, about what's going on in front of you with people. Ask questions about what are they passionate about? How do they love to open up to people? Or try to get to know the person by asking questions instead of just being silent with them. Try to have a good dialogue with people. Try to have an open discussion about things. And try to be open with yourself and other people. You know, so that's everything for this program. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this technique that I've gave you in my program here. And please just use it in your daily life. Try testing it and try to understand how to go about it. You understand? So anyway, guys, I hope that you guys have enjoyed this program. Please make sure that you're using your powers, that you use your gifts, and that you are growing.